Today, our city is recognizing the one-year anniversary of the 1 October shooting that obviously forever changed our community. An unbelievable event shook many of us to our core, and many of those emotions still remain.
Here to talk about the tragic event from a psychological perspective, our friend, therapist, and lifestyle coach, Amy Hachquet. Welcome back, Amy.
Thank you. It's good to be here.
Great to have you. It's hard for many of us to believe it's been a year. And there's still a lot of emotions, a lot of thoughts that people are grappling with. What kind of conversation are you hearing from people?
Across the board, it really varies. I think it depends on how you were impacted by the event and how closely you are associated with it. So the trauma response can really vary. I'm finding from people that they feel surprised that they're doing so well.
Yeah.
They've had a lot of support, a lot of counseling along the way, which has helped promote their healing. Mm-hmm. And then on the other side, those who feel, wow, I thought I would be further along at this point than I am. And so it's important to normalize that these symptoms can persist.
Of course.
Immediately and for quite some time if there's no intervention.
Of course. Mm-hmm. I mean, there's no real foolproof way to just kind of restore order, get right back to the way things were. Mm-hmm. It's kind of always will linger, especially when we hit anniversaries like this. It always comes to the forefront, doesn't it?
Absolutely. There's actually anniversary reactions where it's a visceral response to around the time that these events occur from year to year. So that's also very normal as well.
Mm-hmm. What do you feel is a positive thing we can do at this time of year to kind of honor our feelings and yet, you know, move forward in a way that is, nourishing to ourselves or that supports each other?
I think it's challenging also because as the media headlines shift and flow, as they will, as our friends, family members, our coworkers begin to move back into their normal flow of life, it can feel really isolating if you're still feeling horrible grief, you know, because people's lives were shattered 1 year ago today. And so I think we have to go into it with an attitude of not knowing, not assuming how people are feeling and being extra sensitive and inquisitive and respectful around everything.
Of course. The one thing I find that seems to be a thing, it's more of a society thing in general, is we kind of put our best face on social media. Our Instagram photo has that perfect filter, and life is great, but it might not really be that way. It might just be what they're projecting out into the universe, but that might not necessarily be the reality they're living.
Absolutely. Social media is a tough one. It's been called a highlight reel. I highly agree with that. We don't really know what people are facing, and we're all facing some type of battle, whether it's related to this or other things. So I think just a showing of kindness and patience is especially appreciated today.
Well, I think it's interesting, too, because for me, I feel like there's some kind of expectation that, 1 year out, that we all need to come to a conclusion about, you know, what that event was all about or what it means to move forward. But like you're pointing out, you might not have the answer inside yourself at this point, right? It just might be confusing. It's confusing.
It's absolutely confusing. And I'm asking people, my clients, to involve yourself in self-help methods, get involved in meditation, support groups, do things in between therapy sessions to support your progress. But it is a constant trying to create meaning around this, and it's almost impossible to do that. And we have to come to a level where actually that's okay.
Yeah, no question. Mm-hmm. Is there a way that we as a community can stay sensitive to what happened on this day a year ago and to the people whose lives were affected to that?
I think one of the great things that has happened and that's come up is the Las Vegas Community Healing Garden.
It came out in the course of just 4 or 5 days. That was so remarkable for the city. It was unbelievable.
So I think just showing ways that we're remembering and honoring the community, those impacted, and just staying sensitive as a society in general are very helpful ways to move forward.
No question.
There have been so many people who have created through this tragedy and, you know, so many different ways, like the Remembrance Garden, to just seal the love that has come out of this horrible event around town. Like that is a positive, isn't it?
It is. People have bonded through the tragedy and then also have turned that into a showing of gratitude. There's a group that I read about who's doing 58 acts of kindness in remembrance of the 58 who were who passed that day.
That's so neat.
It was obviously a very tragic day, but it really strengthened the community in a weird way and brought people together and for great for a great cause for the community and for their fellow man, which is amazing. Mm-hmm. Amy, it's great having you, as always.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
This conversation was relevant to you today, and you'd like to support, contact therapist and life coach Amy Hachquet. Her website and phone number are right there on your screen. You could also watch this interview again on our website, LasVegasMorningBlend.com.